the Asur. An enigma to men and dwarfs who know them as High Elves. At the center of the great ocean lies Ulthuan, a paradise created by the Old Ones. But when the Stellar Gates collapsed, demons flooded the mortal plane. All was lost until Anarion the Defender strode forth. The first Phoenix King vanquished the demons with the aid of the Archmage Kalador Dragon Tamer. It was Kalador and his elven mages who created the Great Vortex. A swirling maelstrom that siphoned the excess magic, withering demon kind. With the world purged of chaos, the elves took it upon themselves to become guardians and stewards. The twin-tailed comet is oft seen as an omen, but this time, its wake brought great peril.
The dragon with two tails flies lower than before. Its trail disturbs the vortex.
I have felt a change in the winds of magic.
Then right it, brother. Lead the mages of Saffari. Bring all in the White Tower to bear if you must.
Such lore is currently beyond us.
I suggest a scrying ritual in the Pool of Isha. It may provide us with the answer.
Such a ritual requires fragments of fallen waystones. Far more than we have.
Then we find more. Make ready your ritual, Loremaster Talarion. You will have your fragments.
I shall start the search in Lustria.
Lustria?
My brother will search here, in Ulthuan.
Why do you care so much about the greater world?
Why do you not? Stay here, brother. Protect Ulthuan. But I venture beyond our borders.
And while you meddle in far-flung continents, I will ensure you have a home to return to.
The wave fragments were gathered, the ritual cast. Arcane power lit Ulthuan's skies. Loremaster Talarion, ally of Teglis, was joined by Gallifreyus, squire of Tirion. They would be the prince's eyes as the goddess Isha revealed her prophecy. The Loremaster and Squire saw the Isle of the Dead wreathed in fire, the vortex gone. Without the vortex, chaos floods the world, with Ulthuan doomed to sink beneath the waves. But the Star Crown of Lilith has the power to restore it. The crown was shattered long ago. If the lost shards are reforged, Ulthuan can be saved. Isha has blessed our agents with one piece of the Star Crown, but four shards remain lost. Talarion suggests invoking the spirits of the Phoenix Kings. For who better than a king to find a crown? The cost is high to cast such rituals. More wave fragments are needed. Finavar the Seafarer, the reigning Phoenix King, was called upon to reveal the second shard of the Star Crown. The wave fragments are cast so the tides move at the seafarer's command. The living king has done his part. Now it is time to evoke the royal spirits of old. Cordadris, the Scholar King. His knowledge bequeathed to those who searched, including where the third shard lay, and how to slay the worm that hoarded it.
Begone! Servant of Chaos! Strike, Gallifreyus!
Time is against us. There are others that perform their own rituals of dominance over the vortex. Bel-Shannar, the Explorer. As he used the stars to navigate the world, their light shone upon the King's lost vessel.
There, Gallifreyus! I see it!
The fourth shard of the Star Crown was found within. Thanks to the Phoenix Kings, the Star Crown is near complete. But there is one who is yet to be evoked. The first, the greatest, the Doomed. Anarion the Defender, the first Phoenix King. It is inevitable that the fifth and final shard of the Star Crown is found upon the sword that doomed the Ursa. They were only here for the shard, but even the Lore Master could feel the sword's pull. And then, something else touched their souls. The fabric of reality was torn. From the realm of ruin, the Skaven's horned god mocked its prey and revealed his plan. The celestial event that weakened the vortex was of Skaven design, a parody of the true comet. The Council of 13, the Ratmen's highest authority, were architects of this grand manipulation. Its task complete and fuel expended, the rocket fell back to the surface. When the wreckage was discovered, its purpose remained unclear until now. It was the catalyst to weaken the vortex and goad the other races into action. They knew the Ursa would seek to bolster the failing vortex, but they were ready. Every ritual cast, the magic was stolen, absorbed into the horned rat's bell. Now soaked in ritual power, the bell will be moved to Ulthuan's heart. If it tolls 13 times, the horned god shall emerge from the vortex, the world doomed. Then the god was gone, but in its place came a swarm of his children. Where there was two, there is now one. Thank you. Is that enough to make a difference? The Star Crown reforged. But the crown alone is not enough. It must be born into the vortex, delivered to Kalidor by a hero worthy of Saffari. And yet the chittering Skaven lurk, defiling Ulthuan, awaiting the Horned One's arrival. The vortex must be reclaimed, or the world is doomed. A horned god banished. Vermin purged from the island's shores. Ulthuan's defenders are brothers in arms again. And a hero. A lore master, one who has proven worthy of the Star Crown, to bear its power, walk into the vortex, and become the Maelstrom. Ours is a world of fleeting glory, but it is glory nonetheless.